Peace and light to everyone out there. This is Corey, Mother's House Podcast in the building. We're going to talk about Childish Gambino dropping a new song, a new video, new visuals for This Is America. We're going to try to break it down. And you know how we do. We go a little deep. You know, it may not be exactly what it's meant to be, but this is what we pull from it. This is what I pull from it personally. You know, this is Corey Thoughts. And we're going to chime in on it. So let's get it. And this is basically my review, my interpretation of the video. So it opens up with Childish Gambino with an older man, an older gentleman comes to sit down. He's inside a warehouse. That warehouse, I believe, is supposed to represent how the music industry and how corporations kind of run America. That's why he got it inside of a warehouse. I think that's the telling, you know, for this video, for the visuals of this video, and for the song title. It all have a personal meaning to it, even down to the factory. It got old cars like GMs and old American-made cars in the video as well. Supposed to represent, you know, how America is a manufactured country, built off the blacks. He got in the African aspects of the musicality. You know, music comes from African people, you know, from the diaspora. We sing a lot of spirituals and a lot of things, so he tapped into that. They also displayed that, you know, that the African aspect that built up these corporations had chimed in on it. So you see an old man sit down with, I believe you, once you see that, you see this old man or father sits down and playing the banjo, supposed to represent the aspect of how our culture is being displayed. And when you see him with the satchel over his head, and Childish Gambino comes and take a shot at him, kill him, it's supposed to represent that, you know, how our music and our talents and our culture is being blindsided and is taken by This Is America. And mind you, once he shoot him, that's when he come out, This Is America. Don't catch him slipping though. You dig what I'm saying? So once he do that, that's supposed to represent how America comes in, swoops in, and steals your culture, your dance, your creativity. And that was supposed to represent. Mind you, a lot of people say that guy supposed to be is I saw somewhere somebody said that this guy is Trayvon Martin's father. Now I don't know. That's probably going a little deeper than what I took from it, because I couldn't really tell if that was Trayvon Martin's father or not. But if it is, you know, there's something else to it too. But it's all open to interpretation. Once he goes into his whole rap spill, you see the children. And these children, you gotta mind you, these children are in uniform. And also, these are African children. And they're dancing with Childish Gambino. But as soon as that happened, as soon as he shoots the guy, he hands his gun over to somebody, to a child, to grab the gun and take care of that gun with care. It also point out how America, This Is America, we take care of our fucking guns, but we don't take care of our people. So that's another aspect that you can pull from it. Also, the children in the background, they come in and they dancing and they turn it up with Childish Gambino. You know what I'm saying? And the instrumentation and the lyrics are very telling, but if you pay attention to some of the visuals, it's chaos all behind these children. If you just focus on and you get lost into the dance moves, to the dance crazes, and how trendy everything seems to be, and how the kids are running up to are being entertained. And it's also showing how entertainment today is glorified by this death culture that is being presented and pushed by America. Because This Is America, we celebrate death culture. And then Donald Glover comes back in like a villain on a cartoon character during a church choir singing, you know, go black man, get that money, go black man, get that money. He comes in, he starts dancing, he's vibing, he's feeling it. And then he turns back around and shoot up the choir. Killing, showing how America not only shoots up and kills, like not even what Dylan Roof did, Not only showing that as well, because you can pull that definitely from that. That's definitely a heavy reference. But also, it's supposed to represent, you know, how America not only kill black culture through their music and dance and food and everything and steal from it. It's also supposed to represent how America kills our spirituality. You dig what I'm saying? Check it out. He comes back and he shoots up the choir and they singing that same hymn, same type of hymn that came from the original, from the black man, you know, playing the banjo, and they doing the African spiritual, you know, aspect of it. And now this, and then they go right back. This is America. Don't catch you slipping though. And it goes right back to that. And then he started dancing, you know what I'm saying? He started dancing and griming to the trap music. You know what I'm saying? And you get captivated right back into the craziness. You dig what I'm saying? With him dancing and acting as if what he just done does not really faze him. What he just done with him killing these aspects of himself. You dig what I'm saying? Killing these aspects of his own culture, his own spirituality. Killing that, and he's participating into it because he's engulfed into what is America. You dig what I'm saying? So, and this is what is America. You know what I'm saying? Mind you, got to keep in mind they are inside a car factory. Also, if you peep game, they inside a factory in all these old model cars. They got like GM. This looks like they're inside Detroit at the Detroit GM factory that which a lot of black people built. A lot of black men and women and has worked and slave had given a lot of labor to these factories to build America, to build this industry that's called America. And he's touching on that as well. Go fast forward a little further. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm kicking up. I'm so pretty. I'm on good. I'm so pretty. You got the Black Death, white guy on a horse. The apocalypse is happening, so to speak, behind everybody within inside this factory. It's within this factory that's called America. You see kids on the top of the factory steps, and they recording everything from their phone. And this is what we ended up giving the kids to have entertainment. We got all the crazy stuff going around, but look what we're mostly focused on. We focus on what's keen to be trend and cool, and that's what America like to present to young black children. Something else that Donald Gambino might have tried to touch into. When he's getting ready to, after he finished dancing, the kids dancing around him, he's come out and he point the gun, you know, blow. I think that was supposed to show that, you know, look. And when he did that, the kids, everybody run away from him because now he's a threat. Because, mind you, America had presented to us that the black man shoots, kills his own culture. That the black man is the person that's going to kill his culture, kill this church family, kill all these people. And he's got nothing in his hand, but it's still afraid, fear for everybody. The black man. And he goes right back into black man get your money, black man get your money, black man get your money. And then you see the black man on the banjo back playing the banjo, talking about everything culturally that we have, everything from the trap music to all the type of music that is coming out today, even the dances that is happening back today. It can be traced back to what our ancestors had done culturally to try to get by, mind you, not the violence. America have influenced the violence within our culture, have influenced the violence within our society, within our communities. You dig what I'm saying? The aspect of them, you know, taking away the jobs, you know, locking up people unlawfully and causing a lot of terrorism and trauma within the black community. On top of that, I think he's also touching on the fact that, you know, with all that being, all this propaganda that been spewed about what a black man is, you know what I'm saying? Is what's causing a lot of fear of what a black man is. You dig what I'm saying? And everybody else trying to tell black people what a black man should be. You dig what I'm saying? Or trying to tell black women what they should be. You dig what I'm saying? this is such a powerful and deep video. Like, you, if you watch this one time, I think you're doing a disservice. I think you gotta watch it several times to pull more things from it. You know what I'm saying? This is probably my first reaction review video for it, but you know, I've seen it probably like maybe 4 or 5 times, and I'm still gonna probably go back and pull some more things from this video, because this video is very powerful, very deep. You know, shout out to the AT Alien, Donald Glover, you know what I'm saying? Hold it down for the home team, you know. But, yo, y'all let me know what y'all think, man. There's another scene at the very end when he starts running, and he's running, and it just showed that, you know, it's another thing that we can tie back into when he first shoots the gentleman in the chair. Everybody's running. Everybody's running, but they don't know what they're running from or what ain't to. It's just, you don't know what the hell going on, really. And at the end, he's running just as emphatically and as crazed as everybody else, to show that even your favorite artist, even your favorite person that probably, you know, that giving you this vibe, that giving you this energy, is on that same shit as everybody else. Like, he's part of the same chaos, because this is America and this is what America do. It caused everybody to go fucking crazy. You dig what I'm saying? So, yo, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section below. This is my deep dive into This Is America video. Shout out to Childish Gambino. This is Mother's House Podcast. And my name is Cole Real Thoughts. Peace. Catch y'all next time. And, y'all be blessed, man.
I will not raise my daughter differently than my mother raised me. The rearing I got from my mother, words cannot express. I could live in any time. I could live in any country. I could live on any planet, and I would be fine.
What was the key? What did your mother know? What truth was coming through your mother that's going to come through you to your daughter?
My mother gave us aphorisms to learn as children. And the one that there are two that stand out foremost in my mind. One is, the inner reality creates the outer form. I learned this when I was in grade school. I was very young. And the other is, the universe bears no ill to me. I bear no ill to it.